If you're looking for intense graphics performance, typically you need to pair your CPU with a GPU. That's a graphics processing unit dedicated to the job. That's a simple thing to do for desktop PCs with all their customizable build options. But for laptops, that's a different story. Because discrete GPUs take up extra room and use more power, you usually only find them in larger laptops usually meant for gaming or heavy content creation. Now, those who are frequently on the go need the thinnest and lightest laptops possible. And in the past, they've had to give up graphics performance. But with Intel 11th Gen Core processors, codenamed Tiger Lake, that's no longer the case. This is Tiger Lake. And I'm here to tell you why our latest mobile processor is a literal game changer for thin and light laptops. And it all starts with the new Iris Xe graphics that are integrated right into the 11th Gen Core processor. Intel Iris Xe graphics can give you up to double the performance over our previous generation in the same power envelope, which is super important for portable battery-powered PCs. So performance is way up, and we're now getting frame rates and image render times that rival discrete GPUs for thin and light laptops. So, how did Intel pull all that off? After all, it's not often that you see a doubling of performance from one generation to the next. In short, it's stronger, it's faster, it's more efficient, and it's even more intelligently designed. Let's start with stronger. The Iris Xe engine is packed with more shading resources than ever. And those shading resources, which we call execution units, or EUs, allow us to apply all the visual effects that developers use to make their games look amazing. Where the 10th gen design had 64 EUs, Iris Xe graphics in 11th gen packs 96 execution units. The more specialized effects or shader programs we can run at the same time, the faster we can complete each frame. And rendering more frames every second translates to smoother performance. And having more EUs also benefits content creation and AI, and the added support for DP4A instructions enables AI usages like video upscaling and background removal. Going from 64 to 96 execution units equates to a 50% gain, so yeah, it's definitely stronger. Now to faster. The benefit of Iris Xe's extra shading hardware is multiplied by higher clock rates, making it possible for the graphics processor to get more work done every cycle. Now, for you car enthusiasts out there, that's like if our 10th gen Ice Lake GPU was an inline four-cylinder engine able to turn at 7,000 RPM. Tiger Lake's GPU is a six-cylinder engine spinning at over 8,000 RPM. And when you increase torque and RPM, horsepower gets a big boost. And that's kind of like what we're doing with Iris Xe. Now, to learn more about the benefits of higher clock rates, check out this video on how Tiger Lake cranks up the performance for 11th gen Intel Core. So, we've covered strength and speed. Now let's talk efficiency. Sticking with the motor talk, it's immensely difficult to design a bigger engine that run at higher speeds and don't use any extra fuel. Now that's a tough task for both the auto and chip industry as you start bumping up against the boundaries of physics. But we did it with Iris Xe by starting at the transistor level. We manufacture these 11th gen Core CPUs using our 10 nanometer SuperFin technology, which features several enhancements that improve transistor performance. When transistors switch on and off faster, we can operate them at higher clock rates for a given voltage setting. And of course, voltage is an important variable because it affects power consumption. And these 11th gen Core processors range from just 7 to 28 watts. In the case of Iris Xe, the GPU runs it up to 1.35 gigahertz. That's an almost 23% speed up compared to the previous generation. Now that covers our engine's higher red line. But remember, Iris Xe also has more displacement compared to 10th gen Ice Lake, meaning it's just got more muscle behind each revolution, or clock cycle. Adding extra execution units to Iris Xe without taking up more room on the Tiger Lake chip required significant changes to our microarchitecture. Intel took the really good foundational groundwork from 10th gen Ice Lake and further improved it for 11th gen Core Tiger Lake. Now let's talk about intelligent design. The EUs were reorganized to get more useful work out of them per clock cycle. At the same time, there's a new highly tuned software compiler in charge of determining how things run on the threads on the EUs. We also made it a priority to keep the GPU's resources well fed with a new level 1 cache, meaning we keep more data close to the units that need it, which improves the rate at which we can load the data from memory. And Since the Iris Xe is armed with more rendering hardware, it only made sense to use a faster 3-level cache able to maintain the engine's balance. If a request for data isn't found in one of those on-chip caches and must be retrieved from main memory, we can now reach over a link that's twice as wide thanks to a second graphics technology interface port. Not only is there now more capacity for data, there's also a new compression algorithm which can cram data into less space. And that's like if you were moving houses and now you're able to fit all your stuff into a truck that's even smaller than before. And that second graphics technology interface port is like a whole new set of lanes for moving trucks to drive on. Data compression is also applied to Iris Xe's media and display blocks too. So if you're streaming video or video chatting or playing a game or recording highlights, the image data shared between the various subsystems on the GPU are moved more efficiently, ultimately giving you great performance on a thin and light notebook. And because we accelerate so much of the media pipeline and hardware, Iris Xe can muscle through the latest games while simultaneously encoding high-quality video. And that's for you streamers on the go. In fact, encode and decode throughput are up to 2 times higher than what they were in the previous generation. Iris Xe is also the first mobile GPU from any vendor with hardware-accelerated AV1 decode. Now, if you haven't heard of AV1, it's the hottest thing in video compression right now, allowing creators to compress content and transmit it efficiently over congested networks with very high quality. Simply said, with AV1, you get better looking video without putting any additional demands on your internet connection. And that could mean more video streams at the same time, or smoother video calls, which are pretty important these days with virtual meetings. Now, decoding AV1 video is really processing intensive, and specialized hardware on Iris Xe handles most of the job without breaking a sweat. And since YouTube, Vimeo, Netflix are all in the early stages of rolling out AV1 encoded video, offloading that decode to Iris Xe is gonna stretch out your battery life while you're binging on your favorite new TV series. For big screen entertainment or multi-monitor productivity, Iris Xe's improved display engine offers a ton of options for attaching to monitors on your desktop or to a television in your living room. The GPU can drive up to 4 4K screens, and it even has the bandwidth to power 8K displays at 60 Hz. And support for HDR monitors carries over from our previous architecture, as does adaptive sync for variable refresh rates. Iris Xe is also the first GPU industry-wide to accelerate Dolby Vision in hardware. Now, Netflix has a good number of shows and movies available in Dolby Vision, and I get pretty excited when those pop up because they look great. Iris Xe's display engine also supports DisplayPort 1.4 and HDMI 2.0, along with Thunderbolt 4 and USB 4 over Type-C ports. But connectivity will depend on the laptop you buy. Software also plays a starring role in Iris Xe's story too. In addition to the performance we get from our wider, faster, and more efficient hardware, the driver team puts significant work into tuning for the latest DirectX 12 and Vulkan programming interfaces. Those are the tools developers use to build games, and every bit of optimization we can squeeze from them translates to better performance, right out of the box. Older games written with DirectX 11 in mind are especially sensitive to driver overhead, so we completely rewrote that component of our software package to minimize latency and prevent stalls in our rendering pipeline. Now, behind the scenes, we're working with game developers to boost performance on Iris Xe even more by taking advantage of features like variable rate shading. This is a technology that allows developers to determine where to spend the most of their computational horsepower. Let's take a look at this example from GRID 2019 from Codemasters. Areas of a scene with lots of color and detail, like everything outside of the car, shaded in green, get the most attention from Iris Xe, while elements with less variation, such as the dashboard and other detail inside the car that don't require as much processing, here in red, are shaded less aggressively. Ultimately, this means that Iris Xe graphics can be smart with its resources, and for GRID, that translates up to a 30% better performance with VRS enabled on Iris Xe. Together, our software stack and hardware engine deliver playable frame rates in games that simply weren't accessible on thin and light laptops before. We're talking about AAA titles, and for multiplayer games, where every frame matters, we're averaging more than 100 frames per second at 1920 by 1080. That's full HD, and in some cases, even twice the frame rates. That's most of everything you need to know about Intel Iris Xe integrated graphics on 11th Gen Core, but there's one more thing. With all this amazing engineering work that we've put into graphics, we wanted to take Iris Xe just one step further, and that's Intel Iris Xe Max, which was codenamed DG1, which puts the same Iris Xe LP from Tiger Lake in its own discrete package, giving the graphics even more headroom. Notebooks that pack Iris Xe Max discrete graphics alongside 11th Gen Core with integrated graphics can use something we call Intel Deep Link, enabling the two chips to dynamically share power for optimal performance between the CPU and GPU. Iris Xe Max excels in AI workloads and hyper-encode for video streaming and other content creation. It's just more graphics goodness, and we're just getting started. Now, those looking for the best high-end graphics performance are still gonna want a desktop PC or a more purpose-built, bigger laptop. But for something you're gonna want to be carrying around with you often, even if it's from your desk, to your couch, to your lap, it's a lot of new technology and innovation in Intel 11th Gen Core processor with Iris Xe graphics. Look for Intel laptops with 11th Gen, Intel Evo, or Iris Xe Max badging. I'm Marcus Yam, technology evangelist for Intel. Thanks for watching.